the video presentation on respiratory system brought to you by registryready.com. In this segment, we are going to study the anatomy and the physiology of the respiratory system. So beginning with the anatomy, so basically the structures that help us breathe. The first one would be the airway. So the airway, which means the door or the passage which is taking you to the main room, which is the lungs, where the gases are exchanged. And then the other structures that help facilitate this movement, so the muscles around the lungs, the nerves which are relaying information to the muscles. So when you speak about the main muscle of respiration, we talk about the diaphragm. And this diaphragm gets its information from the phrenic nerve. The phrenic nerve is made up from the cervical spinal nerves, which is the C3, C4 and C5. Now coming back to the airway begins with the mouth and the nose. We take a breath in either from the mouth or from the nose, and both structures take air into the lungs. So the little passage behind the nose and the mouth is known as the pharynx. This pharynx continues to become the larynx. The larynx continues as the trachea, which divides into two main branches. These two main branches leading to the two lungs. So let's look at them individually again. We said that the passage behind the mouth and the nose, the common passage where the air meets, is known as the pharynx. So the part of the pharynx behind the nose would be known as the nasopharynx. The part behind the mouth is known as the oropharynx. And the part of the pharynx, the base of the pharynx, is known as the hypopharynx. But we also eat from the mouth. So where does this food go? This food also enters the hypopharynx, but at the base of this pharynx, or at the level of hypopharynx, the pharynx divides into two tubes. Anteriorly, it continues as the larynx, and posteriorly, it continues as the food pipe, which we know as the esophagus. So the windpipe, or the anterior pipe, which is a continuation from the pharynx, is known as the larynx. Larynx is made up of a number of cartilaginous rings, at the base of which there is an opening known as the vocal cords. They are basically two flappy cords which open and close as we speak and we breathe. So when you're breathing, these cords are open so that the air can enter the trachea and then into the lungs. When we speak, these flaps are closed so that they can generate the noise or the voice. So basically these vocal cords, they become the voice box. So at the base of the larynx or just above the trachea, you have the vocal cords. The trachea is made up of, again, cartilaginous rings. It bifurcates or it divides into two main branches, which are known as the bronchus. And these bronchus enter the lungs and they keep further dividing until the final structure or the functional unit of the lung, which is known as the alveolus, is seen. So within the lungs, the structures would keep dividing till you have the little sacs of air cells. These sacs of air cells are known as alveolus. Let us look at the airway again. We said that the vocal cords are present at the base of the larynx or just above the trachea. All structures above the vocal cords constitute the upper respiratory tract. So in the upper respiratory tract, we have the nose, we have the nasal passages, we have the pharynx, and we have the larynx. All structures below the vocal cords become the lower respiratory tract. So what all is there in the lower respiratory tract? You have the trachea, you have the bronchus. The bronchus further gives out many branches which would become the bronchiolus. So the bronchiolus is a part. And the final structure, the final unit of the lungs where the gas exchange takes place, alveolus, also is a part of the lower respiratory tract. So this is the basic anatomy of the respiratory system. Let us look at how the gas exchange takes place. We said that the main cells that perform the gas exchange are the alveolus. These alveolus are basically a number of air cells which are come together. These alveolus have high concentration of oxygen, because when you take a breath in, the oxygen comes into these alveolus. This alveolus is met up by the capillaries, which are formed by the blood vessel, which is bringing blood to the lungs. So this capillary, which is still bringing blood into the lungs, contains deoxygenated blood. Deoxygenated blood, which means less in oxygen, high in carbon dioxide. At this level, where there is high carbon dioxide, less oxygen, meets with the alveolus, which is high in oxygen. This high oxygen moves from the alveolus into the capillary. This process, where oxygen moves from a gradient of high concentration to low concentration, this process is known as diffusion. Anytime a gas moves within the concentration gradient, that means it moves from a high level to a low level, that process is known as diffusion. So the oxygen moves from the alveolus into the capillary. Now this blood vessel, which contains high level of oxygen, thanks to its exchange from the alveolus, is taken back to the heart. The vessel that brings in deoxygenated blood to the lungs or to the capillaries would be small branches of the pulmonary artery, whereas these capillaries, which form oxygenated blood and they start forming branches, they ultimately become the pulmonary vein and they take blood back into the heart. So the important part about respiratory physiology is to understand the process of diffusion. Diffusion means whenever a gas passes from a high level of concentration to a low level of concentration. Alveoli has high level of oxygen, so the oxygen moves from the alveoli into the capillaries, and in exchange this carbon dioxide from the pulmonary arteries gets back into the alveoli. This carbon dioxide, which is entering the alveoli, leaves the lungs and leaves the body when you breathe out. Once again, when you breathe in, you breathe in oxygen. The oxygen enters the lungs through the alveolus, it diffuses into the capillaries, into the pulmonary vein structure. From there, this oxygenated blood is taken to the heart. In the process of diffusion, where oxygen moves from the alveolus to the capillary, carbon dioxide is given back into the alveolus and it is removed from the body by